Friends, my name is Kapil Goyal, and in this tutorial I will teach you how can you create load more button in PHP. I have already created a database AJAX and a table apps countries, and here we have 30 records in this table. And I have already created two files, one is index.php and second is load.php. Now first we will create a database connection for fetch our data. MySQLi connect, host will be localhost, password will be blanks. Our database name is AJAX. Now we will run a query, we will execute a query MySQLi, sorry, MySQLi query. This one is first parameter will be connection and second is our query. Select star from our table name is apps countries. Here we will fetch only two records. This one is our data, store this in a variable. Now we will show this data in a table id table underscore data. This one is our id. We will use this id to append data in our table using jQuery. Now first create table header. This one is id th, this one is country code, and third one is th country name. This one is name. Now we will create a while loop for show our data. While dollar row equal to MySQLi fetch association, this one is our variable. Here we will make another row td dollar row, first column is id, second column is country name, copy paste, and third column is country name. Copy and paste it here. Now if I refresh this page, now you can see the two records here. Now store the last id in a variable, id equal to this. After that after this loop we will create another row here td, sorry, create a button here ID of this button is load underscore more and load more. Give a another attribute data ID. Here we will store our ID. Echo ID and give this row a ID also. Remove row. Okay, now save this. And if I refresh this page, here you can see the load more button. It is not looking good because call span 3. Now it should look fine. Now you can see here data ID is equal to 2. Now we will include jQuery CDN. Copy this URL and script source this one. Now our jQuery has been included. Now at the bottom write script. Here first document dot ready function. Now this is our syntax for jQuery. Now we will create another function dot on document and here paste your ID. Data is coming from Ajax. That's why if we directly paste the ID here, then it will not work. Now fetch the ID here. Dollar dot data bracket and ID. Now if we alert this, we should get the ID. Now it is working fine. Now we will write our Ajax code. Dollar dot Ajax first pass the URL. URL will be load.php. This one is our URL. Type will be post. Now third parameter will be data. Data ID comma colon ID. Success function. This one is our success function. Here we will get the response. Now we will remove this row after success. dot remove dollar, this is our table ID. Copy this, we will append data in this dot append, this one is function response, save. Now go to your load.php file. After that, first create a database connection here. This one is our database connection, and data limit equal to 2, limit will be same. Order by ID here, same order by ID, limit will be 2. And where ID is greater than dollar underscore post, this is our post variable here, post this. Now if I run this, then we should get the result. You can see number of rows equal to 2. Now make a while loop, go to the file, copy this one and paste it here. Now store, now we I am removing this, and we will create a fresh script here. Output, first take a variable, output is equal to blank. Now while dollar row equal to MySQLi fetch association, here pass your variable and make and output dot equal to in between the inverted commas, we will write our HTML for table row. td sorry, its row and its ID. Copy this and paste it here. Now go back to your table, country code, paste it here, copy this and paste it here. Now create one more row output dot equal to for load more button we will create a new row. You can also copy this one, paste it here and you have to paste it outside the loop. Store the last ID of the loop equal to, this is the row ID, copy this and paste it here, and we will return output variable. Save this. Now if I run my code, now you can see it's working fine. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel.